Hello, everybody. Well, once again, welcome to Fresh Fire Prayer Ministry, where we keep the fire of the Holy Spirit burning. Today is the day the Lord has made. We'll rejoice and be glad in it. If you were directed by God to join in the Easter fast, we want to pray with you and believe God with you that whatever you are believing God for, the Lord God Almighty will come through for you and that you will not be disappointed. Whatever you are trusting God for, that the Lord will be merciful to you just as he came through for Esther. It doesn't matter what you are going through. When you humble yourself, the Bible says God will lift you up. And fasting is a way we also humble ourselves before the Almighty God. And as you are seeking the face of the Lord, whatever issue it is, as we are about to pray, as you commit these issues into God's hands, you can be rest assured that the rest, God will take care of the rest. You have done your part, the rest belongs to God, and he will not put you to shame. Just as the Bible has said in Hebrews, that anyone who puts their trust in the Lord will never, the word is never, be put to shame. So as you trust God, have confidence and have faith in him, and he will bring you out of every situation. Let's just go before God right now and just begin to thank him. Let's thank him right now. Let's thank him for his goodness and his mercies, which endure forever. And after that, you are going to present your issue, your case to God. And the Lord will answer you. The Lord will come through for you. The Lord will bring direction to you. Whatever help you need, as you cry out to God, we serve a faithful God. So let's start off by thanking him and blessing his holy name for giving us today, preserving and protecting us, and even helping us to see the new week. Let's thank God.
Q&A session is over.
Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Father, we thank you, we worship you. We thank you for the beginning of this week, God. Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness. I thank you because you've been a faithful.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We bless you, Lord. We give you all the glory, Lord. We give you all the honor. We give you all praise. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy, Lord. Lord God Almighty, you are worthy. You receive all the praise.
My Father, I thank you. My Father, I adore you. My Father, I praise you, Lord. I raise my voice in adoration.
Rebo sikara ba shete rebo sata yada ba zuri yanta rebo rebo kura ba yada ba rebo rebo. Mozali kata ya hatuli bili yanta mozali bili yanta. Father, we worship you. We worship you. We worship you. We glorify you, Jesus. We magnify you, Jesus. We adore you, Jesus. For you alone deserve to be praised.
Presence of your angels, Lord, I worship you. In the fullness of your majesty, Lord, I worship you. You are God. All by yourself, God. I thank you.
I'm
like unto you, God. Yeah, I'm like unto you. We know a generation that you are God. You are God all by yourself. You are God all by yourself. Hallelujah to the Lord of God. You are the King of Kings. You are the Lord of Lords, and you are the Lord of Father. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. We don't think I praise you, God. So I praise you in all things. I praise you in all things. I praise you in all things, Lord.
Bibles to Isaiah chapter 43, Isaiah 43 verse 26, Isaiah chapter 43 verse 26, the Bible says, put me in remembrance, let us argue our case together, state your cause, that you may be approved right. Other version says that, put me in remembrance, let us contend together. State your case, that you may be acquitted. So now God is telling you, bring me to remembrance. Remind me of my word. Remind me of my promises. Now let us contend. It's like, let's come to the court. Bring me to the court. And now bring in your strong argument. Bring out your strong argument. And now bring your argument before me. Declare thou that thou mayest be justified. It is like you are bringing God to the court and you are stating your case before him, arguing with him based on his promises concerning your situation. And God says that, put me in remembrance. Bring your strong argument. Declare it thou unto me. Let me know what my word says about your situation, that I may justify you. So now, I don't know why you are fasting. I don't know what you are believing God for. I don't know what you are trusting God for. Now bring your strong argument before God and tell him why he should come through for you. Tell him how you want him to intervene. Tell him how you want him to help you. Ask him and you will be acquitted. You will leave here tonight on this prayer line being acquitted. And this week you will see his glory. So lift up your voice and begin to pray and ask the Lord. Amen.
Q&A session is over.
I will record the I'm
Fasted for that 3 days with the Israelites. She needed favor in order for the king to even address her situation. Because the Bible says that without a king calling you, you couldn't go to the king. And if you went to the king without him inviting you, you could be killed. So Esther could not go to the king. But when she fasted and waited on the Lord, the Lord gave her favor. The Lord granted her favor. And that was the favor that she was just passing by in front of the king at a distance. And the favor of the Lord was so much upon her that it attracted the king's attention. And she called Esther. And when Esther came to the king, because of divine favor, the king was willing to give her anything that she will ask. He says that Esther, ask me anything you want, and I'm willing to give you half of my kingdom. This is a king who was ruling a whole empire. Because of favor, she was willing to give Esther half of his kingdom. All Esther needed to do was to ask. Today, the Lord will grant you favor, that no matter what challenges you are going through, the favor of the Lord will make a big difference. A big difference. The favor of the Lord will make a big difference. The favor of the Lord will make things begin to work for your advantage and not your disadvantage. The favor of the Lord will begin to make things go for you and not go against you. The favor of the Lord will settle every dispute. The favor of the Lord will bring goodness, good things into your life. It doesn't matter how bad situation is in your marriage. It doesn't matter if you are looking for a job. It doesn't matter if you are looking for a spouse. The favor of the Lord is what will change the situation. You are going to pray and ask the Lord to favor you. that, Father, I seek for your favor in my life. I seek favor at my workplace. I seek favor as I'm looking for a job. I seek favor for financial breakthrough. I seek your favor. Whatever favors you need, ask and it shall be given to you. Ask the Lord to grant you favor in Jesus' name.
Q&A session is over.
Jesus.
Q&A session started.
Amen. Our next prayer, we're going to ask the Lord. When Esther fasted, there was an evil report, evil decisions that was taken by Haman against Israel to destroy them. But because Esther fasted, the Lord reversed the decision. The Bible makes us to understand in Psalms 4 verse 2, it says that there are those who want to turn our glory into shame. There are those who are seeking to turn your glory into shame. What it simply means is when Joseph's brothers wanted to turn his glory into shame, what happened? When they saw his coat of many colors and they heard of his dream and they saw how his father loved him, they turned his glory into shame. And what did they do? They wanted to kill him. But they succeeded in selling him as a slave. That is when your enemies are trying to turn your glory into shame. When they see who you are and they want to now reduce you to nothing. They have seen how good your marriage is and somebody is just jealous about your marriage. So for that reason, they want to destroy your marriage by causing your husband to divorce you because they are envious. They have seen how your job is and the money you are making. They are jealous, so they want you to lose that job. They have seen how things are working for you, so now they want to afflict you with some disease or to attack you. The devil, it says that Psalms 4 verse 2, they are turning your glory into shame. So Haman wanted to, Israel were free, and he wanted to annihilate all of them. He wanted calamity, evil to be done to them. We are going to pray that every evil decisions that are being taken against you, every evil judgment, any evil thing that is being planned against you, that the Lord should reverse it. The Lord should reverse it and turn your shame into glory. And turn your shame into glory. Some of us, decisions are being made against us. Somebody is about to make a decision whether to pick you for the job or not to pick you for the job. Some of you, your husband is contemplating whether to divorce you or not to divorce you because somebody is putting pressure on them. They are going to say, Father, every evil decision that is being taken against me, Lord, reverse it. Lord, reverse it. Some of you are going for court cases. Some of you are going to take exams. Every evil decision that is going to be passed against me in this month, in this season, in this year, Lord, turn my shame into glory. Turn every bad report into good report. Turn every bad report into good report. Every evil decision that it's being passed against me, I reverse it. I switch it. I reverse it. I switch it. I switch it. I switch it. I turn my shame into glory. I turn every evil decision into good report. In the name of Jesus Christ, every witches that are planning evil against me, I turn it into good report. In the name of Jesus Christ, begin to pray and switch every negative report that is being released against you, against your children, against your health, against your finances, against your destiny. Lord, I turn my shame into glory. I turn every evil report into good report concerning my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, begin to pray.
Q&A
in Jesus'
session
name.
Is over.
I reverse it. In the name of Jesus. Father, we turn every evil report, every evil decision. We overturn it. We overrule it. We turn our shame into glory. In the name of Jesus, we turn our shame into glory. Every shame that has been packaged against us, we turn it into glory. We reverse it. In the name of Jesus, we reverse it. Every evil report, we reverse it in Jesus' name.
It is my property.
I can every report of this meeting.
Zara
In Jesus' name I pray. In the name of Jesus.
Q&A session started.
Amen, 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 and amen. May the Lord reverse every negative decision that are being passed against you, which hasn't even manifested yet, but they are releasing against you. May the Lord reverse it. May the Lord reverse it and turn it around, even in the name of Jesus. May the Lord reverse every shame. Every shame. Turn your shame into glory. Turn every curse against you into blessing, in the name of Jesus. Turn every disfavor to your favor, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. May every evil decision passed against you be reversed, be revoked, be overwritten by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, no weapon formed against you shall ever prosper, in Jesus' name. The Bible says that when Esther fasted also, the Lord brought deliverance to Israel, because the Haman wanted to annihilate them, to kill them all, and to destroy them. So a day was set for their destruction. Don't know the day the devil has set to break your marriage, the day the devil has set to destroy your life, the day the devil has set to cause that disappointment, to cause that evil, that sickness to materialize, to cause weeping, crying, sorrow, frustration to manifest in your life. But you're going to pray that we serve a living God, that the Lord should deliver you from every evil plans of the enemy. Whatever they have orchestrated, whatever they have planned, they had planned on a specific day. The king has endorsed it because Haman had convinced him that on this particular day, I want everybody who sees the children of Israel to kill them. So on that certain day, they were going to be killed. But the Lord brought deliverance. The Lord brought deliverance. Whoever is planning to destroy your marriage, whoever is planning to hit you with sickness, whoever is planning to cause you to fail in life, whatever demon has been sent for to come and destroy your life, whatever evil spirit has been sent forth to bring disappointment and cause you to fail and cause you not to break through, in the name of Jesus, Lord, deliver me. Lord, deliver me. Lord, deliver me from the hands of my enemies. Deliver me from the traps of my enemies. Deliver me, O God. Deliver me, O God. Deliver me, O Lord, from the traps of my enemies, from the plans of my enemies, from the plot of my enemies, from the evil agenda of my enemies. Whatever they have planned against me, against my marriage, against my finances, against my health, against my destiny, against my children, against my spouse, against my job, Lord, deliver me. Lord, deliver me. Every accident, deliver me. Every sickness, deliver me. Every marital issues, deliver me. Every problem they are planning out against me at my workplace, Lord, deliver me. Anything they have planned to destroy me, Lord, deliver me. Deliver me from all evil. Begin to pray for deliverance, that whatever your enemies are plotted, devised in their chambers, in their coven, in their secret place to bring evil and calamity and disaster to you, may the Lord arise and deliver you, because you have put your trust in Him. He can't fail you. He can't put you to shame. He can't allow your enemies to triumphant over you. So Lord God Almighty, in whom you have I trusted, let me not be put to shame. Don't let my enemies rejoice over me. Deliver me from the hands and the traps of my enemies. Deliver me from the snares of my enemies. Deliver me from the nets of my enemies. Deliver me from their evil agenda. Those who are attacking me at my workplace, those who are attacking me in my marriage, those who are attacking my life and my destiny, Lord, deliver me. Begin to pray for deliverance in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for deliverance. Lord God Almighty, I pray for deliverance. I pray for deliverance. Deliver my wife, Lord, from all evil. Deliver my wife from all evil. Deliver my family. Deliver my family. Deliver their family. Deliver everyone on this whole life. Deliver us, O God. Deliver us from all. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we ask for your deliverance. 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 Deliver me from all evil. Reba ba suna mashata de bri shabri. Reba ba 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 ba. Against Israel. There was a man behind the scene. There was a strong man. His name was Haman. He was the one who went to tell the king that, "King, there are a group of people I want you to wipe out and annihilate. And if you annihilate them, I'm even willing to give you money. I'm willing to give you more money if you can only. There are people who are willing to pay people to make sure that your life is ruined, your life is destroyed." Haman was that person. But God turned the table around. The very pit he dug to destroy Israel, he fell into that same pit. He made a gallows in order to hang the man of God, Mordecai. But the same gallows he erected to hang that man of God is the same gallows that God turned things around, that he was hung. You are going to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, any obstacle, any Haman, any individuals, any demonic spirit, any household witches, any household wizards, any witch, any wizard, any strong man, any spiritual policeman, any familiar spirit, every marine demon, whoever is responsible for causing problems in my life, whoever is behind the scenes working against me, trying to frustrate my life, trying to humiliate my life, trying to put me to shame, trying to stop me from fulfilling my destiny, trying to deny me access to my miracle, trying to stop me from getting a job, trying to destroy my destiny, trying to block me. Father, let that Haman, let that devil, let that strong man, let that demon, let that witch, let that unclean spirit, let it die, let it perish by fire, let it die, let it perish by fire, let it die, let it perish by fire. Begin to command any demonic spirit, witchcraft spirit, agent of darkness, any strong man responsible for your problem, blocking your opportunities, blocking your miracles, blocking your blessings, causing pain and confusion in your life, cause them, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, let them perish, let them die, let them perish, let them die, let every human die by fire. In Jesus' name, begin to pray.
Let every human perish by fire. Any obstacle to our miracles, let it be consumed by fire. Every obstacle to my miracles, let it be consumed by fire. Anyone behind my problems, let them be consumed by fire. Let them perish, let them die. 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 Let them be eliminated. Liba Sunama Zunama Zatan, Ribaba Sunama Rababam, Ribaba Sunama Rabazatan, let them die, let them die, let them perish, let them perish, let them die, let them die, let them perish, let them perish, let that demon, let that witchcraft spin, let that wisdom, let that agent of darkness, let them perish, Ribaba Sunama, Rigandaba Dizan, Ribaba Dizania, Ribaba Zunama Zan, Ribaba Zunama Zatan, Ribaba Zunama Rabatan, Ribaba Zunama, Ribaba Zunama Rabat, let my enemies perish. Let my enemies perish. Let my enemies perish. Let my enemies perish. Let them perish. Those who are militating in witchcraft against me, trying to cause me to fall, trying to cause me to fail, trying to destroy my life, trying to destroy my destiny, let them fall. Let them perish. Let them perish. Let them die. Let them perish. Let them die by fire. Die by fire. Die by fire. In the name of Jesus, let them perish. Riga da 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 let them die, let them die, let them perish. Lord, expose my enemies, destroy them, destroy them. Destroy them by fire in the name of Jesus.
Q&A session started.
In the name of Jesus, may the Lord arise on your behalf and cause your enemies to perish. Perish in the name of Jesus Christ. Isaiah chapter 54, verse 4. Isaiah 54, verse 4. Do not be afraid. You will not be put to shame. Do not fear disgrace. You will not be humiliated. You will forget the shame of your youth. And remember no more the reproach of your widowhood. There are five forces. There are five forces that are fighting against people. Five things you want the Lord to deliver you from. Five things. Shame. Lord, you are going to pray, oh God, deliver me. There are people who are planning to put you to shame. They are planning to bring disgrace in your life. Planning to bring reproach. Planning to humiliate you. Five things. Shame. Lord, you are going to ask the Lord that because you have sought his face, because you are seeking his face, because you have put your trust in him, the Lord should deliver you from shame. The Lord should deliver you from disgrace. The Lord should deliver you from reproach. The Lord should deliver you from humiliation. The Lord should deliver you from disappointment. Oh God, in you have I trusted. Father, deliver me. Deliver me from the spirit of shame. Deliver me from the spirit of disgrace. Deliver me from the spirit of reproach. Deliver me from the spirit of humiliation. And deliver me from the spirit of disappointment. Lord, deliver me. Lord, deliver me. Lord, deliver me. In the name of Jesus, we are going to pray that the Lord will deliver you from these five elements. That it will not happen. It will not happen. It will not happen in your life because you have chosen to put your trust in the Lord.
Do you know what it means to be disappointed? Meaning that every time you are waiting and expecting something good to happen, your enemies will always cause you to miss it. Then you'll be disappointed. Do you know what it means to be put to shame? Or to be humiliated? When you are ashamed, or you are put to shame or reproached, you can't even come amongst people because you will be wanting to hide away because your situation is so bad that you yourself, you feel ashamed to allow people to know about you or hear about you or see you. To be disgraced, you are going to pray that, Father, not this time around, not this year, not this week, not this time. Whatever they are doing, whatever my enemies are doing to put me to shame, to disgrace me, to reproach me, to humiliate me, and to disappoint me, Lord, deliver me. Deliver me, five things. Deliver me from shame. Deliver me from disgrace. Deliver me from humiliation. Deliver me from reproach. And deliver me from disappointment. In the name of Jesus Christ, begin to ask the Lord, Father, in your mercy, deliver me. Deliver me from these five things. From shame, from disgrace, from humiliation, from reproach, and from disappointment. Deliver me, O God, and show me your salvation. Begin to pray for the Lord to deliver you. In the name of Jesus. Lord, deliver us. Deliver us, O God. Deliver us, O God. For in you, O Lord, have we trusted. In you, O Lord, have we put our trust. Let us not be put to shame. Lord, deliver us, O God, from all evil. Deliver us, 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 deliver us. Reba basuka basika raba zuna basata. Zemiri musika raba ba 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 ba. Rima da raza biru ya zade biru basata ya bada basata. Reba basuna basata raba basata raba basata raba basata. Zemiri musika da 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 ya kari biru biru. Reba ba 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 zuna basata ya da 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 ya kari biru. Reba ba ba zuna basata biru 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 biru. Muna ba da 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 ba. Reba ba ba biru biru ya kari biru 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 biru.
From your life, may the Lord
protect you from this spirit in the name of Jesus. May the blood of Christ block this spirit from coming into contact with you in the name of Jesus Christ. You will not be put to shame. You will not be disgraced. You will not be reproached. You will not experience disappointment this time. You will not be humiliated in the hands of your enemies. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Psalms 35, verse 4. Let them be confounded and be put to shame, those who seek my soul. There are those who wanted to put us to shame. You are going to pray. The Bible says that the pit they have dug for you, anyone who digs a pit for his brother, they will fall into their own pit. Anyone who digs a pit for another person, they will fall into their own pit. Here, the Bible is saying that, let them be confounded and be put to shame, those who seek my soul, those who are seeking after your soul, seeking after your shame, seeking after your disgrace, seeking after your reproach, seeking that you become disappointed this month, disappointed this season, disappointed this year, those who are seeking you to be humiliated, those who have dug a pit for you, those who have released evil arrows against you, those who are just waiting to hear bad news from your end, today you are going to pray, Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, let them be put to shame, those who want to put me to shame, let them be put to shame, those who have turned my glory into shame, Lord, put them to shame, put them to shame, put them to shame, the pit they have dug for me, let them fall into their own pit, in the name of Jesus Christ, every arrow they have released against me, let it backfire, let it return back to them, Father God, cause my enemy to be put to shame, cause my enemy to be put to shame, those who have risen against my marriage, those who have risen against my job, those who have risen against my health, those who have risen against my destiny, those who have risen against my business, those who have risen against my children, those who have risen against my spouse, put them to shame, put them to shame, put them to shame, begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Father God, confound. Let our enemies be confounded. Oh Lord, let our enemies be confounded. Let our enemies be confounded. Let our enemies be confounded. Put them to shame. Those who are seeking for our head. Let the baribada badu zenimiliyanta. Ribada badu zenimiliyanta. 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 Ribada badiyanta. Zenimiliyanta. Zenimiliyanta. Riba baba baba. 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 Lord, anyone who has dug a pit for your children, let them fall into their own pit. Those who are trying and waiting for a shame and reproach and disgrace and humiliation, Lord, put them to shame. Put them to shame. Put them to shame. Put them to shame. Their pit they have dug for us, let them fall into their own pit. Their pit they have dug for us, let them fall into their own pit. In the name of Jesus, deliver us, O God. Reba ba 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 ba. Deliver us, O God. Put our enemies to shame. 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 In the name of Jesus. Let them be put to shame. Those who have risen against us, let them be put to shame. Let them be put to shame.
Q&A session started.
In the name of Jesus. Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3. Jeremiah 33, verse 3. Call unto me, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things. Psalms 50, verse 15, it says that, call unto me in the days of trouble, and I will answer you, I will deliver you, and you shall glorify me. You are going to ask the Lord to grant you breakthrough. I don't know. You are going to pray for breakthrough concerning your job. Breakthrough, be specific in the area you need a breakthrough. I'm not talking about long-term breakthrough within the next 4 months, this week, this month. What breakthroughs are you waiting for? Are you looking for? Lord, grant me breakthrough. Grant me breakthrough. And I'm breaking through by force. I'm breaking through by fire. I'm breaking through by force. I'm breaking through by fire to receive my miracle job. I'm breaking through by force to receive my husband back. I'm breaking through by force to receive restoration in my marriage. I'm breaking through by force to receive peace and joy in my marriage. Whatever you are looking for, I'm breaking through by force, by fire, to receive total restoration. For everything I've lost to the devil, I'm receiving it back in the name of Jesus Christ. I'm receiving breakthrough. Those of you who are jobless, you are receiving your job. You are receiving your job. You are receiving your job. Wherever your job is, they should call you. They should call you and give you that job. You are receiving your breakthrough by force. You went for the interview. You are expecting to hear from them. Lord, I receive my breakthrough by force, by fire, in the name of Jesus Christ. You singles looking for your husband, wherever my husband is, I'm breaking through by force. I'm breaking through by fire. I take it by force. Wherever my husband is, I command you to appear. I command you to show up in my life. Everything you are looking for, breakthrough. I'm breaking through. I'm breaking through, and I'm taking it by force. I'm breaking through. I'm taking it by force. I'm breaking through, and I'm taking it by force. If you need healing, breakthrough and receive your healing. If you need financial breakthrough, breakthrough and receive it by force. Whatever you are looking for, marital restoration, your husband to return back home, peace in your marriage, your children to excel, whatever you are looking for, pregnancy, whatever issue you are looking for, I am breaking through. I am breaking through. That cycle of delay, that cycle of joblessness, that cycle of marital stress, that cycle of financial stress is over. I'm breaking through. I am breaking through to get married. I'm breaking through to receive my healing and deliverance. I'm breaking through to receive my own apartment, my own job. I'm breaking through. I'm receiving my restoration. I'm breaking through to receive my money back. I'm breaking through. Whatever you need, this is the time. Call on to God. He will answer you. Begin to break through. Break through by force and take it by fire. Break through by force and take it by fire. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Disappointment.
Chapter 10, verse 11. Romans 10, verse 11. The Bible says that anyone who puts his trust in God will never be disappointed, will never be put to shame, will never be disgraced, will never be reproached, will never be put to shame. Anyone who puts his trust in the Lord, we have put our trust in the Lord, and the Lord will not put you to shame. The Lord will not cause you to be disappointed. So begin to thank God for your breakthrough, for your miracle. Thank God for giving you that healing. Thank God for restoring your marriage. Thank God for giving you your job. Some of you are receiving your job instantly. You are receiving your job this week in the name of Jesus Christ. You are receiving your healing. You are receiving your husband back. You are receiving your marital restoration. You are everything that you need. The Lord is doing it. Let's have faith. Let's believe. And the Lord will not put us to shame. So begin to thank God for restoring you. Thank God for your miracles. Thank God for your breakthrough. Begin to be specific on the things you are believing God for. And thank God that, Father, I thank you that you have answered my prayers. I thank you that you have given me the job. I thank you that you have restored my marriage. I thank you that you have given me the financial breakthrough. I thank you that you have brought in to pass my purposes. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for your healing. I thank you for deliverance. I thank you, Lord, for making a way for me. Whatever you have prayed, begin to thank God specifically on that thing. That, Lord, I thank you that the miracles will show up from tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll get that phone call. Tomorrow, this week, I will get that miracle, that breakthrough. That money will be provided. The bills will be settled. The money will be raised. God, you are going to do miracles. Thank you, Jesus. Begin to thank God for an answered prayer. Thank God for an answered prayer. Thank God for an answered prayer. Thank you, Jesus. 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 Thank you, Lord. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. For another prayer. We worship you. Thank you. 43:18. Do not remember the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I do a new thing. It shall spring forth. You shall know it. He says, shall you not know it? I will even make a road in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. Behold, I am doing a new thing. This week, God is doing a new thing in your life, and a new thing in your situation, a new thing in your marriage, a new thing in your finances, a new thing concerning that court case, a new thing as you go to take the exams, a new thing is being done to you concerning that joblessness. You are going to receive that miracle job, you are receiving your healing, you are receiving your breakthrough. Situations will change because God is doing something new in your life. Believe it, receive it, and you shall see the glory of the Lord. Amen. May God bless you all. Tomorrow we are continuing with the fasting from Monday to Sunday, 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. And on Friday to Sunday, if God leads you into the Easter fast, you can do either 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. or you do the 24 hours. May the Lord bless you. And in this coming weeks ahead of us, it will be filled with testimonies and the glory of the Lord. Mark today down, for the Lord is surely going to do a new thing. This week, be in expectation. Some of you, as of tomorrow by this time, you'll be having a testimony. You'll be having a song to sing. You'll be having a smile on your face. You'll be having a dance at your feet because the Lord has changed your situation. The Lord has come through for you. The Lord has given you a testimony. Receive it and it shall come to pass. This week, you will break through. This week, you will see the glory of the Lord. The bills will be paid. Your healing is sure. God will come through for you. He will make a way for you. He will make a way for you. He will turn situations around. He will give you victory. May God bless you and be with you and your family. In Jesus' name, amen. See you tomorrow, same time. Bye.